Hi there. My name is Steve Schwartz, and I'm the founder of the LSAT blog. I've been coaching the LSAT for over 10 years now, and today I wanted to share my thoughts on the digital LSATs that are offered via Kindle and Nook. These are not the real digital LSAT. These are not interactive in the way that the digital LSAT will be. The Amazon Kindle and the Barnes & Noble Nook offerings are there just because LSAC is concerned about piracy, and they want an easy way to sell digital copies. But you can't really interact with these exams the way you will be able to when LSAC starts offering the digital LSAT. The digital LSAT will let you flag questions. It'll let you bubble and answer choices using a stylus. And the digital LSATs offered via Kindle don't have any of those features. They only have the standard features that any Amazon Kindle or Nook ebook will offer, like maybe highlighting something or marking a certain page down. But in terms of interacting with the text itself, it's not going to be the same. For example, also the digital LSAT lets you have a countdown timer to do 35-minute sections. You're not getting that on a Kindle, believe me. So these LSAT prep tests, you don't want to get them in this format. It's worth getting the paper and pencil format LSAT prep tests for now. Maybe LSAC will release more digital LSATs in the interactive format in the future. But for now, if you want individual exams, you've got to shell out the $8 to $10 per exam until LSAC releases the exams in the 80s in books of 10. But while it's $8 or $10 per exam, it's worth it because just a few more points on the LSAC could get you significant scholarship money or help you get into a better law school. And the most recent LSATs are the best indication of where the LSAT currently stands. And while the older exams that are in books of 10 are still perfectly valuable and useful, you'd be selling yourself short if you didn't arm yourself with the best and most recent LSAT prep materials possible, which of course includes the newest LSATs. Anyway, if you have any other questions at all about applying to law school or taking the LSAT, please feel free to reach out. I love hearing from students. And in the meantime, I'll wish you all the best. Take care.